Hello and welcome to the episode 58 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today's highlights include a package tour, a recording session, and a shooting for a film. On the 27th of February 1962, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed a lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool, their 143rd appearance at the venue. In 1963, the Helen Shapiro package tour arrived at the Rialto Theatre in York. Shapiro was still off because of her cold and was substituted again by Billy Davis. Since the show is very short today, allow me to point out the genius of these package tours and spend a minute or two talking about them. What were they? The idea was simple. They were a tour of many bands packaged together. This, naturally, had many advantages from the point of view of the organization. You could lure people into a concert on the strength of the offer. In the case of the Helen Shapiro tour, you had seven different pop bands and singers coming to town. Hard to beat. In addition, the organizers would incur in less expenses for traveling and accommodation for seven bands together than they would have if they had organized seven different tours. From the point of view of the bands, it was a good deal too. The concert was short, so you didn't have to work that hard if you were a top act. If you were just starting, instead, you'd have the chance to have a show in front of a crowd drawn by the biggest artist, with a little space to concentrate on your best songs. All this with a payment that more or less was decent and proportional to each artist's appeal. Theoretically, the audience was happy too. You'd go for the main artist or two, and then you'd still enjoy a variety of acts. But, as it often happens, the theory didn't conjugate too well into practice. In the long run, the public started clamoring for more stage time for their heroes, and happy to pay for lesser-known bands that they didn't particularly care about. And so, package tours declined and eventually disappeared by the end of the 1960s. In February 1963, though, one could find six package tours traveling around the United Kingdom, with more than 40 bands involved. Let's move to 1964. More session at Abbey Road, London. During the first one, between 10 a.m. and 1 p.m, And I Love Her was finally recorded to everyone's satisfaction, in two takes. In the afternoon, between 2:30 and 7:15 p.m, two more songs were completed. Tell Me Why in 8 takes and If I Fell in 15 takes. Finally, in 1965, the Beatles completed the sequence for their performance of Another Girl on Balmoral Island, Bahamas, for their still-unnamed second feature film. Balmoral Island was renamed Discovery Island during the 1990s. Well, this must be the shortest episode in the whole history of all podcasts. But as I said before, this show focuses on what the Beatles did, and if they didn't do much for one day, I won't keep chatting for 3 hours straight over nothing. If you want to force the Beatles to do more and support my efforts for this podcast, please visit www.simonmas.com/support. I can't promise I can force the Beatles to do much, but I'll do my best for the episodes. Drop me a line if you fancy, if there is a comment section wherever you're listening to this podcast, or if you want to be sure that I do get your thoughts, use the contact form on my website. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.